Today I'm going to show you how to import data from Excel into MySQL using Python. We'll start by installing the xlrd library, which is used for extracting data from Excel spreadsheets. And keep in mind that xlrd only supports the classic XLS file, not the XML formatted XLX file. You also need to install the MySQL DB module in order to connect to the database. Both are easy to install, and links to both of their download pages are available on my blog, which you can find a link to in the description of this video. So after installing xlrd and MySQL DB, create the table that you'd like to use in your database if it's not already created. And my table looks like this. So the primary key is an auto-incremented ID, and the other 13 columns are a mixture of integers and strings, which will be populated by the Excel data. Now, to create the Python code, I like to start with writing out pseudocode in plain English, detailing what it is that I'd like the code to do. Then I turn the pseudocode into comments and write the actual code. And for time's sake, I already wrote out the pseudocode and commented it out, which you can see here. And the actual code is written as well, so I'll just be copying and pasting it over, explaining each part. So you want to start by importing xlrd and MySQL DB to make them available. So first you want to open the workbook and find the worksheet. And so to open the workbook, set a variable, book, and set it equal to xlrd.open underscore workbook, and then enter the path to and the file name of your XLS file. And then to access the sheet, you can either use its location in the Excel file with the sheet by index method, this method here, or by the sheet's name with the sheet by name method. So since I don't need to do both, I'm going to go ahead and just comment this out. So next, you need to establish a MySQL connection. And to do that, just set a variable, database, equals MySQL DB. Connect, and then enter your full host name, username, and password, and then specify the database. And there are several other parameters that can be used as well, like port if it's different than the default MySQL port. And you could also set the path to a configuration file using read underscore default underscore file, so you don't have to expose your username or password in the code. Okay, so next you want to get the cursor. And basically, that's used to read the database line by line so that you can perform a query. And so then you want to just set a variable, cursor, equals database.cursor. Then you want to actually write out the insert into SQL statement. And you can see I have insert into orders. And then I have my 13 columns. All columns are here except the ID column, which is, again, auto-incremented. And here are the values here, and then here are the placeholders for the values. All right, so next you want to create a for loop. And this for loop will iterate through each row in the XLS file. And it creates an array called R. And you want to make sure to start at the second row, which is why I have a 1 here. And you only do that if you have headers in your Excel file, so which I do, and I want to skip them. And then you establish the cells here that you want to use for the iteration. Now you want to assign values to match the placeholders from up here. And this is placed in the loop as each row in the Excel file is different. And I just need to tab over one more time here to make sure that's in the loop. All right. And then you want to execute the SQL query. And to do that, you do cursor.execute, and then enter the variable names for the query, which is here, and assigned values, which is here. Now we exit the loop, and then we need to close the cursor. So the cursor.close closes the previously open cursor. Make sure to do this before you close the database connection so you can still commit the data manipulations to the database using database.commit. And then finally, you want to close the connection to the database and then print the results. Here I'm just saying goodbye, and then I have variables that will calculate the number of columns and the number of rows in the Excel file, and then I have a print statement here that just prints that information out. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and save this file. So now let's test this out. So I'm going to open up the MySQL console so you can see what data is already in the table. So I'm just going to select all from orders. See, it's empty. So let's go ahead and run the file now. So I'm going to open up command prompt. I'm going to cd over to where my newly created Python file is. And then I'm just going to run the file. And I named it PyTest. Okay, so I got the print statement saying goodbye. All done, bye for now. And so I just imported 13 columns and 3160 rows of data from Excel to MySQL. So let's just verify that the table is not populated with data, which it is. All right, some more fun stuff with MySQL and Python will be coming soon. Thanks for watching.